two rivers that are Lavada and Lamassu. Put together, got Lamassu. The British couldn't pronounce Lamassu for some reason, so they called it Benares. But the original name of the city was Kashi. And we visited there a few years back. And we went to the Manikarnika Ghat. There's many ghats there. Vishwashwamedha Ghat is where they do the Ganga Aruti. The river Ganges, or another Ganga, flows through India and in many holy places along the banks of the Ganga, they do Ganga Aruti. So the Ganga Aruti that they do every evening at sunset in Varanasi is the most spectacular aruti you've ever seen. Anybody been there and seen that? Is that amazing, huh? Now in Haridwar, they also have a Ganga Aruti, and that's the biggest. It's huge, it's packed. In fact, it's so crowded, it's almost a little over the top. Just 45 minutes north of Haridwar, on the banks of the Ganga, is Rishikesh. And there, their Ganga Aruti is the sweetest. So we have the largest, the most spectacular, and the sweetest, the most intimate. So when I was in Varanasi, we got our room just overlooking the river. We came in that evening, took rest. Then I got up real early in the morning and we had our window facing the river Ganga. And as the sun gradually made its appearance, it slowly came up, I noticed the boats were floating this way. The river was flowing this way. You know what that means? The river flows from right to left, and you're facing the sun. What does that mean?
North.
It means it's flowing north. And I was thinking, wait a minute, how is this possible? Because the Ganga always flows south. So I had a friend there who used to work with the Archaeological Survey of India, and I was meeting him later that morning for breakfast. So I asked him, I said, how is it the Ganga flows north? And then he told me that the Ganga flows south until it comes to Varanasi. Right at the top of Varanasi is a big Shiva temple. Then Ganga flows around the city of Varanasi, flows back up to that temple, then turns around and goes south. And he says that this way, the Ganga pays her respects to Lord Shiva, offers her pranams at his lotus feet, goes around his town, comes back, offers more pranams, and then turns and goes south all the way, then Bengal. Because it was Lord Shiva that captured Mother Ganga when she came to this planet in his locks, matted locks. If you go to Rishikesh, they have the most beautiful Lord Shiva Murti you ever saw in your life. Mother Ganga Ganga at the Paramahniketan Ashram. So we went there at the Manikarnika Ghat, where Lord Chaitanya went, and right next to it was the Burning Ghat. So we came over to the Burning Ghat just to see how everything was going. An old Brahmin approached us and said he was representing the trust and would we like to give a donation. So I felt generous that morning. I gave him a large donation. And he was so pleased that he took me on a 2-hour tour of the whole Ghat and explained to me everything about why people come to Varanasi to leave their body, which, you know, bodies coming in all the time, explained the whole process. He watched several bodies being burned. He told us that the fires are going day and night, rain or shine, they never stop. And then he showed me a flame there, and he said, this was the flame originally lit by Hiroshima. And all the fires that are lit for the bodies that are burned, they get a pile of jute and light that from the Hiroshima's fire. They take it and light the original, the other fires that burn the bodies. It takes 360 kilos of wood to burn the body. And they recommend that the ladies don't come. Because if you cry, that prevents the soul from leaving this earthly planet because he becomes attached and hears the cries of separation. So the ladies are going to come. They have to do all their crying at home. No crying there. Because the idea is you want to liberate that soul. Lord Shiva comes and whispers the name Ram to everyone's ear. And another thing is, after the body's burned and everyone leaves to go, you can't turn back and look, because that again creates an attachment. You just have to turn around and walk and never look back. As they were bringing the bodies in, they're wrapped in white linen. They dump them first in the Ganga. So they're sopping wet before they burn. And that's to purify holy waters in Mother Ganga. Then they sprinkle sandalwood dust or shavings and ghee and other things. And if people want to give some gold or something to the departed soul, they leave that, then they burn the flames. He explained everything to us. Then before we left, he wanted to give us a gift. He brought us up to Lord Shiva's fire. He took some ash and vibhuti. He wrapped it up for us. So we took that home with us. Very special. So from Varanasi, we're going to catch a train to Calcutta. Calcutta is the home of Kirtan, or I should say Bengal. Calcutta is the capital city. There's a village called Navadvip and Mayapur, which is actually the home of Kirtan, where Lord Chaitanya started the Kirtan movement. And they have a style of Kirtan that's very mystical. So we're going to do that. Then you're going to have to concentrate in order to capture the melody. Okay, we're going to focus on concentration. This isn't a simple melody at all. It's very mystical and powerful. It's called Yama.